Our investigation into bullying at a major high school in Canterbury continues tonight. More than a dozen families at Ashburton College claim they were abandoned after reporting bullying, saying staff there allowed violence and abuse to fester for months at a time. Thomas Mead has the second instalment in his exclusive series.
They are allegations of suffering and pain.
Fat baby
cheese face.
I'm going to beat her up.
As family after family emerges, claiming they were ignored.
I do remember yelling at them, crying, saying, when are you going to do something when she's a statistic?
This young woman quit Ashburton College in 2020, aged 15.
And it got so bad to the point where I wanted to, you know, like, stop living. And I went to my counsellor and I said to her, hey, this has happened. This bullying isn't stopping, and I have a plan in place to end my life.
Saying her schoolmates bullied her for months after learning she had been sexually assaulted. But her school file only recorded bullying once.
No one got told off, no one got any sort of punishment or anything. They didn't even get, like, nicely spoken to.
Another victim's family described being referred to truancy services, saying the school was concerned over a low attendance rate, but not the bullying behind it.
She'll get into trouble for being late too, do you know what I mean? Like, because she's afraid to go in.
Ashburton College didn't respond to those allegations in their statement to One News, but said it uses a mix of tools, including the Ministry's Positive Behaviour for Learning, or PB4L framework, which is a school-wide approach designed to build a culture of positive behaviour. It's also planned a NetSafe session for November. But this expert believes bullying needs a more targeted response.
What really needs to happen here is an intervention where, you know, it's a community approach where the school organises some kind of hui or open forum where they openly listen.
And the government needs to mandate and fund intervention programs.
And I do feel that when teachers and schools have a choice, it often gets swept under the carpet or thrown away into the too hard basket.
Students have already been asking Ashburton College to listen for years.
Nothing. They did nothing to help it. They didn't want to know it was going on.
Sarah Bramhall graduated back in 2018 and says she still has serious anxiety from repeated body shaming during her time at school.
I actually multiple times thought about committing suicide because of being told that I'm useless, because I've been told that I wasn't worth it. And that's something that no kid should go through.
Leaving victims feeling hopeless.
Nobody cares.
Nobody likes you.
Watch your back. You're such a liar.
As the same old cycle repeats.
And Thomas joins us now live to Nakwe. Thomas, Ashburton College says it's reflecting on its processes. Did it say what that means?
That's right. In a letter to parents and caregivers, the school said it was reflecting on its processes, its systems and its support for students. We'd love to tell you some more about that, but unfortunately we can't because they did not provide any more information. We'd also love to sit down for an interview with either the school principal, Ross Priest, or anyone from the school board, but they declined that opportunity when asked. We sent them a long list of questions, but many of those also went unaddressed. And the school would not say whether it would apologise to any of the families of the victims involved. Many are now calling for the principal, Ross Priest, to resign, saying he does not have the skills required for this particular job, and it's their children who are paying the price.
And Thomas, the school argues that it has limitations. Is there anything that it can do to help?
That's right, that'll be a question that many viewers have at home. What can a school do in this day and age? Ashburton College uses a number of tools available from the Ministry of Education and NetSafe. But tomorrow night, we're going to be continuing the series looking at some of the targeted programs that are available, including a specific prevention and intervention program for school bullying that is used in dozens of schools in New Zealand, and what will be the third and final instalment in this series.
Thomas Mead, thank you.